Morning, everybody. Myself, Basavam. I am working as assistant professor in St. Martin's Engineering College in the ECE department. And today I am going to deliver a lecture on Introduction to Microprocessor and Microcontrollers. So let us discuss about microprocessor and microcontrollers. And as we know that microprocessor and microcontrollers are the building block of embedded applications, where the embedded applications are using in our day-to-day life, starting from our home and in vehicles, industries, everywhere we can find an embedded applications. So in order to build any embedded applications, it is very important to know about microprocessor and microcontrollers. So let's start with the microprocessor. So what is processor? First of all, the processor is nothing but is a CPU in a computer which process the data according to the input is given by the user. So for example, this is a processor generally. So to the processor we need to give an input. So that is input. So after giving an input to the processor, it processes the data according to the input given by the user, and finally it will produce an exact output whatever we want. So that is nothing but processor. Inside the processor we can find a different computational blocks, that is control unit, execution unit. So these are the building block present inside the processor. So as we are giving an input to the processor, that just it process it and gives the output. So now coming to the microprocessor. Micro means small. It is a tiny size processor which can process all the data which we are giving to the processor and process it and gives the input. So how does it process? For example, if I want to add two numbers, what I will do, first I will give A as a one input, B as another input, that is 4 plus 5, generally we will get a result of 9. So how this processing all happens in the microprocessor is, it has, first it will fetch the data and it will decode and it execute. So let us start with the microprocessor, the definition of a microprocessor. That is, the microprocessor is a central processing unit which performs the arithmetic and logical operations according to the predefined instruction set. Means it is a CPU which processes the data. Means, or we can call it as, which performs arithmetic and logical operation on predefined. So it performs arithmetic and logical operations by using predefined instruction sets. So we need to give an input to the processor so that it can process it according to a predefined instruction sets. By using a user, he will give a predefined instruction set. So that is nothing but the definition of microprocessor. It is a central processing unit which performs arithmetic and logical operation according to the predefined instruction sets. That is nothing but microprocessor. So let us, we have in the practically where we will be using a microprocessor. So look at your computer system where we have a CPU inside it. So that is nothing but your microprocessor. Intel Pentium and some of the processor, what it will do, it will take the input from the user and process it according to the predefined instruction and it will execute it. Beautiful example is your PC. Like in the PC you will be having a microprocessor, and you take your laptops, personal computers, everywhere you can find a microprocessor. So actually this microprocessor will be used for a general purpose application. So very important point here. So most of the time it will be used for general purpose applications. So general purpose application in the sense, you take an example for a PC or a laptop. So where, so what is the use of PC and laptop, which is used for doing a task, that may be Microsoft operations or Word operations, or you can take PowerPoint presentation operations or anything we can use with the help of our PC. Means we can play a video game, or we can play games, and we can listen to music, we can watch a movie. That can all done with the help of the microprocessor based devices. That means it is generalized task. So for the specific operation we will have a microcontroller, but for the general purpose application we will be using a microprocessor. So coming to a microprocessor, we have a different variations, like electronic chip, that is 80, 85, 80, 86. So let us come to the basic syllables. We have a processor called as an 8086 microprocessor. So this we will be using in our subject to study about 8086 microprocessor. So now I will give a brief introduction about 8086 microprocessor. So I hope the processor is nothing but it performs an arithmetic and logical operations according to a predefined instruction sets and according to a input given by the user. So let us have some basics of 8086 microprocessors. So usually Intel has come up with a beautiful processor, Intel 4004 in the year of 1970s. So where it has only 4-bit microprocessor, just I am reading what, and it can handle 4-bit of a data at a time. So later on, due to advancement in semiconductor technology and in nanotechnology, so 8086 microprocessor that is built by Intel, it has 16-bit, it is a 16-bit microprocessor. That means it can handle 16-bit of a data at a time. Means, so for example, this is a bit handling, this is a memory where I can store 16-bit of a data, 16-bit each I can store, and each bit having one flip-flop. As you know, that flip-flop which is used to store 1-bit of a data. So let us, next specifications for this is, it has 20-bit address bus. So totally we have 3 buses. In 8086 microprocessor, one is an address bus, second one is data bus, and another one is control bus. So as I already told you, the processor will do the operation in 3 steps. One is fetch, next one is decode, another one is execute. So first of all, what is bus? As is similar to your transportation bus, which carries the passenger from one place to another place. Similar way in a microprocessor, buses are which carries the data from one memory location to another memory location. So they are divided into 3 types. One is address bus. So a very important point here is the microprocessor can access the data from the memory. So in order to access the data from the memory, we need to know its address. So each and every memory location in 8086 microprocessor has its own unique address. So by knowing that address, then only we can access the data in that particular memory location. For that purpose, so bus will carry the address from one memory location to the another memory location. I can call it as from processor to the memory location, the address bus will go. For example, I can say this is my memory location. For example, say it is 4000H, so on up to 4002 location. I want to access the data from this to this memory location. For example, I have stored 1234, I want to access it. So first, to access this particular memory location, I need to know its address. The processor will use this address by calculating. By calculating the address, it will give. So the address bus which carries this address, and it will go to this particular memory location and get the data. So this is the work of address bus. Address bus which carries the address from one memory location to the another memory location. So second one is data bus. As the name itself indicating, it is data bus which carries a data from one memory location to the another memory location. So now we got an address from the address bus. Now we need to carry this data to the processor again. So what it will do? We have a data bus through which we can carry this data from memory location to the any other registers for calculating whether it may be any operation, arithmetic, logical operation. Similarly, the control bus. Control bus mainly have two signals, that is called as a read and write signal. So whenever you are accessing the memory from the outside devices or within a devices, whether you want to read it, means you want to put a data, or you can take a data, for that purpose we will be using these are the control bus, which is mainly used for memory interfacing time, that is control bus. So these are the very important bus. So in 8086 microprocessor we have a 20 address bus. That means we can access 2 power 20, that is approximately 1 MB. So we can access 1 MB of memory in 8086 microprocessor. Basically, an important point is microprocessor doesn't have any memory, but as it has a 20 bit address bus, that's why we can access 1 MB of memory. So similarly, it has 16 bit data bus. Already I have told you what is the use of data bus. As it is a 16 bit processor, it has 16 bit data bus. So similarly, the operating conditions may be 10 MHz to operating frequency. As we know that the frequency which is used for enhancing the speed of operations, we have a 10 MHz, and it has a different register, general purpose register, around 14 general purpose register we have. So these are the basics ideas of 8086 microprocessor. Now, as I told you, introduction to microprocessor and microcontroller. Briefly, I will tell about what is microcontroller. So now you got an idea about what is microprocessor. Generally, the microprocessor, it is used for general purpose application. It is 16 bit microprocessor, only used for general purpose application most of the time. So now we will be using a microcontroller. So microcontrollers is an integrated circuit where it is a microprocessor plus other peripheral devices. It is an integrated circuits, and it is a combination of microprocessor plus other peripheral devices. Along with processor, we will be using a peripheral devices called as timer, counters and memory. So this makes a single electronic smart system, that is called as a microcontroller. So microcontrollers are mainly used for a specific application. As I told you, the microprocessors are actually used for general purpose application, but whereas microcontrollers are used for specific applications. Specific application in the sense, I can tell an examples, like you take a washing machine, air conditioner, and traffic light control systems, weather monitoring system, and smart irrigation system, where all these operations are specific. For example, you take we have a washing machine, we can't replace the operating systems or functionality of washing machine with an air conditioner, because the operations for a microcontroller are used for only a specific purpose, not for the general purpose applications. So we can see most of the embedded applications are built with a microcontroller. Actually, in the market, we have a different kind of microcontroller, that is 8-bit microcontroller and 16-bit microcontroller. According to applications, we will be using an 8051 microcontroller. So, thank you very much.
Namaskar, sir.